the first part of the terrain editing video, I explained how to create a simple slope around the house. Now it's time to learn how to add bumps, depressions, cutouts, and paths to customize the landscape in a house design project. The landscape around your house can be presented as a number of isolines, which, in essence, are lines drawn on a map connecting the same height points. Depending on the isoline's proximity and their values, we get a clear picture of what the terrain around the house looks like. Should we have a steep slope or flat ground? All of that can be achieved with the isoline's representation. To draw such lines and to facilitate terrain editing, we created three special tools: elevation line, elevation spline, and elevation point. The elevation line tool allows you to create isolines. Using the elevation line tool, I click several times to create an enclosed contour and press escape or double click in the end. This is what I get. Isoline elevation can be controlled via the Object Properties tab of the inspector. The font size for the isoline value on the 2D floor plan can be changed using the 2D Properties tab of the inspector. Same as with other enclosed contours in Live Home 3D, by double-clicking on the isoline, we enter the editing mode to adjust corner points and segments roundness. The Elevation Spline tool provides more freedom when it comes to isoline drawing. It can be compared with the freehand drawing tool and is ideal with tracing isolines from an imported terrain map. This way, you can achieve an identical copy of the landscape around your house. Of course, you can edit isoline contour and value at any time. It is recommended to avoid isoline crossing to create smooth and correct terrains. Finally, we come to the elevation point tool, which is mostly used for adding peaks or depressions to terrain models. Here's an example of what can be achieved using these terrain tools. Next, I will share a few tips for creating complex terrain models. First, elevation for each isoline can be set to positive or negative values. By experimenting with elevation values, you can achieve the best transition from one height to another. Second, if you need to create a house on a hill or a mountain, similar to this one, a good practice would be to add several stories until your house reaches the necessary height. Then you use the project tree to hide stories you don't want to be visible in the design. And finally, to better distinct terrain form, it is recommended to apply a different material to it. Otherwise, the terrain form can blend into the background and it will be hard to see all the details. Applying the same material should be done on the final stage. The remaining terrain editing tools are pit and pathway tools. The pit tool is mostly used to add cutouts in the ground, such as garage access for houses on the hill. But perhaps the most frequent use for the pit tool is to create swimming pools. To make a pool, I need to make a cutout in the ground, apply a material to each side accordingly, add side elements and steps with the help of shapes or the building blocks, add a plain surface imitating water, and finally, apply water material to it. Adding pathways as the final element of the design is quite fun. By default, the contour points that form a path have the Use Auto Elevations option enabled. This helps to add a path on the ground in just a few clicks. More advanced and precise pathway creation will require you to manually set elevation for each pathway point using the Object Properties tab. Well, that's basically all about terrain editing tools.